Yeah. Hey, St. James, make some noise. I don't know about y'all, but I want to see the Holy Spirit activate in this place right now. Yeah, let's go. Okay. Let the Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Okay. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Yeah. Let the Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Let's go. Let the Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Activate, I elevate. I thank God for this brand new state. He put some food up on my plate. I thank God he made a way. Jump with a purpose, God is so worth it. Thank you for God, you know that it's surface. Getting this cash, you know that it's worth it. I got the drip, you cannot just skirt. God, he made a way. I thank God every day. Ain't no facade, no we don't play. No we don't play, no we don't play. Jesus died on the cross for our sins. Like where do I begin? Getting that cash, you know what it meant. Getting that money and I'm going in. Yeah, Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Let's go. Let the Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Yeah. Let the Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Let the Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. I know that he made me away. I know I woke up today. I know that I'm getting that cake. All I can do is pray. All I can do is pray. Praying them every day. Tell them to get out my face. Cause I've been through the rain. Yeah, I've been through the pain. Yeah, yeah, I'm going insane. Yeah, yeah, I stay on the track. Yeah, Jesus Christ got my back. Yeah, devil, he's staying intact. Yeah, I'm prayed up. Don't worry, I'm prayed up. Don't worry, I'm prayed up. Yeah, activate, meditate, get in that cash. You know that I can't relate. Get in that money, I'm getting it every day. Why is you talking? I need you to get out my face. Elevate, elevate. All I wanna do is elevate. All I wanna do is elevate. All I wanna do is elevate. Elevate. I'm on time, no, I'm never late. I'm on time, no, I'm never late. I'm on time, no, I'm never late. Elevate, elevate. I'm on time, no, I'm never late. I'm on time, no, I'm never late. I'm on time, no, I'm never late. Let's activate. Yeah. Let the Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Yeah. Let the Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Peace, joy, activate. Love, live, activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Let's go. Let the Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate. Holy Spirit activate.
I know it's Pentecost Sunday and all, but the Holy Spirit's showing out. See, we came with an expectation to meet the Holy Spirit, but the Holy Spirit didn't beat us here. Because man, oh man, the Spirit is high in this place. Give God a shout of praise if you are grateful that God has activated in your finances. God has activated in your health. God has activated in your marriage. God has activated in your kids. God has activated in your mental. Come on, give God a shout of praise if you are grateful for the Holy Spirit activated. Woo! I'm going to listen to the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit says, move, get out the way, get out the way, so that he can have his way. Because I believe that somebody came here for a word, transformed their life. And that's what you're going to get today, because today is all about the Holy Spirit. And you cannot encounter the Holy Spirit without in some way being transformed. And today is Pentecost Sunday, and quick crash course if you don't know what Pentecost means. Pentecost commemorates the day that the Holy Spirit descended upon the apostles and the rest of the followers of Jesus. And the Bible says that when the Holy Spirit settled among them, appeared what looked like fire or flaming tongues. So that's why you see a lot of us in red today, in the remembrance of that. So Pentecost Sunday today is all about the Holy Spirit. I'm going to go and get right into the word, because just in that text, there were tongues of fire. I believe that the Lord wants to give you fresh fire in your life today. Pray with me if you will. Lord, we thank you for your Holy Spirit that activates. Lord, you activate in us even when we try to deactivate you. We thank you for being a God of grace, a God of mercy, a God of love, and a God who's God all by himself with no help from nobody else. God, we love you. We thank you. And hey, the Holy Spirit about to activate. Amen. So the song we just sung, obviously, is Holy Spirit. And that term actually has its roots from like a viral clip that aired from Family Feud. See, some of y'all already know where I'm going. Let's take a quick look at the screen.
China?
Yes, sir.
Carney did okay. She got 184. China, you need 16 points to win.
Okay.
I'm gonna ask you the same five questions you can
ask. Hold on.
Okay.
Holy Spirit, activate.
Oh no.
Holy
oh,
Spirit,
no. Oh,
activate.
No.
Holy Spirit, activate. 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 All right, let's go.
11 years has never happened before.
Right, right, exactly.
Holy Spirit, activate. Holy Spirit,
activate.
I said, okay.
Hey, what a word, what a word. Funny thing is, I truly believe that a lot of us could benefit from this mindfulness, right? Maybe your kids spilled something on the carpet, you told them stop eating in the living room, and what? Holy Spirit, activate. You beefing with that one coworker that they know that you don't like them, right? And they still trying you. Holy Spirit, activate. Holy Spirit, activate. Right? Some of y'all need to activate the Holy Spirit, because some of y'all be in traffic. Holy Spirit, activate. Activate. Or maybe your kids say something smart to you in public, and you know because you're in public, you don't want to cut up too much, so you what? Holy Spirit, activate. But beyond this, as a mindfulness technique, this is a word for us today, because this woman, her name is China, and she truly believed that in that moment, she needed the Holy Spirit to activate live on Family Feud. And how many of us know that when we feud with life, the challenges and the hardships and the trials of life, that we need the Holy Spirit to activate? So today I will be speaking from the sermon title, obviously, Holy Spirit, activate. And I never forget, there was one particular day. Anybody like snow cones? Okay, good. I ain't the only one. Okay. I love snow cones, and I have this snow cone shop that I go to, like, faithfully, right? And I go so much that, like, the employees, they, like, remember my face, and they also, like, remember, like, my order. Anybody got that place they go to where you, like, cool with the employees because you go there so much? Yeah, this is the place for me, for my snow cone place. And the funny thing is, right, I never forget the one day when I got there, the cashier, she says, can I ask you a question? And I'm like, hold on. You trying to ask me a question? I'm thinking she's trying to say, you got a girlfriend, you know? So I'm like, okay, I turn on my little smooth voice. I'm like, okay, yeah, you can ask me a question. What's up? And I'm waiting. And she said, you come here all the time. Why don't you activate your rewards? Some of y'all already know where I'm going. I said, what do you mean by rewards? She said that customers who come here a lot, typically, they make an account with us. They have an account with us. And this rewards account qualifies them and gives them access to rewards, promotions, specials, and benefits. She said, as much as you come here, dude, if you'd activated your account that you already have, you would have been getting a whole bunch of stuff. In other words, she told me that I had been missing out on so many things that could have been beneficial to me because I had an account but didn't activate it. Oh, I'm about to heat up. There are so many Christians today who have an account with the Holy Spirit but did not activate it. There's so many Christians who have an account with the Holy Spirit but have not activated it. And the thing is, I truly believe that just like how our favorite stores, Starbucks, GameStop, Target, right? All of our favorite stores and restaurants, they have rewards account that gives things that are beneficial to you. I truly believe that the Holy Spirit has rewards for you spiritually that could benefit your life if you just activate it. So today is about helping you activate the Holy Spirit. But I truly believe that a lot of us do not activate the Holy Spirit because we do not know the right question to ask. Everybody say, uh-oh. This question is not what is the Holy Spirit, but who is the Holy Spirit? Who? Not what is the Holy Spirit, but who is the Holy Spirit? I'm going to give you a perfect example. You got Michael Jordan and you got the Jumpman logo. On the screen, when you see the Michael Jordan Jumpman logo, naturally, intrinsically, you start to ascribe value, meaning, and respect to the Jumpman logo, not because of what it is, but really because of who it is. Think about it. Not because of what it represents, but because of who it represents. Not because of what it resembles, but because who it resembles. In the same way, all I'm trying to say is that if we rephrase the question from what is the Holy Spirit to who is the Holy Spirit, we'll begin to attribute value, meaning, and worth to the Holy Spirit because we now know who the Holy Spirit is, who the Holy Spirit really represents, and who the Holy Spirit really resembles. Really resembles. In fact, it's a scripture, 1 Corinthians 2:10. Here we go. God has shown these things to us through his Holy Spirit. Through what? My Holy Spirit. No, his Holy Spirit. God has shown these things to us through his Holy Spirit. I'm going to break this down like real simple. Through his Holy Spirit. Follow me. Because his Spirit is holy, the Holy Spirit is his. If you want to take it a step further, because his Spirit is holy, the Holy Spirit is his Spirit. In other words, the Holy Spirit is God. The Holy Spirit is not a thing. The Holy Spirit, everybody say being. Some of the seasoned Christians are like, I already knew that. Tell me something I don't know. Well, I came to make sure that the season, I came to put some seasoning on the seasoned and unseasoned. I need 8, 28, 78, 38, all to understand who the Holy Spirit is. Because if you don't understand the who, then you won't understand the why. When somebody comes to our door that we don't know, what are two questions we asking? Who are you? Why are you at my door? There's a who and a why. And if you don't understand the who, you will misuse the why? And the Bible tells us why the Holy Spirit is here. John 15:26, you'll see it on the screen. I will send you the helper. The what? From the Father. Then this is Jesus talking. Then he says it again. The helper is the Spirit of truth who comes from the Father. So the role of the Holy Spirit is to be the helper. So we got who? The Holy Spirit is God. His role is to help. You got God the Father, Jesus the Savior, and the Holy Spirit the Helper. I truly believe that God gave us the Holy Spirit as a helper because hope really isn't always enough. Hope is good. Hope is great. But imagine this. Imagine if you drown in, like, in water. Somebody save me. And somebody from far away says, I hope you make it out. You look at them like they crazy. You don't need hope. You need what? Help. You need help. And God knew that in this life, all of us at every age would need help. Which leads me to my first point. Y'all ain't ready. The Holy Spirit activates help for the heavy. The Holy Spirit activates help for, everybody say heavy. Robert, let's get it. Pop a squat right here. Raise your hand if you work out. Don't lie now. I ain't raised my hand, you know what I'm saying? All right, we in church, don't lie now. The Holy Spirit is watching. All right, so the Holy Spirit activates help for the heavy. You understand? In gyms, typically when people are lifting weights, they are accompanied by a, everybody say, spotter. Now, the spotter takes on the role, technically, of a helper because the spotter's role or the spotter's job is that when the person who is lifting the weights starts to struggle with the heavy weight, the role of the spotter is to help them lift the weight. Now, Robert is here simply because Robert represents the spotter. Not only does he represent the spotter, but he represents the Holy Spirit as the spotter. Because the Holy Spirit activates help for the heavy. See, in life, life gives you three types of weight. If you've lived on this earth longer than 2 seconds, because they already give you weight, as soon as you come out your mother's womb, they slap you on the butt, life gives you weight, something to lift real quick. You go find out real quick. Real quick. The first type of weight that life gives us is lightweight. You know, everybody say lightweight. It ain't nothing but a little lightweight. This lightweight represents things in your life that you lift with no trouble. You lift with no sweat. You lift in your sleep. You lift with one eye open. These are the sins you don't struggle with. Somebody else may struggle with not wanting to cuss somebody out, but you're like, man, I'm good. These represents the things that come very easy to you. And the things that are lightweight, we lift easy. It's easy. I ain't got to sweat. I ain't got to worry about it because it's what? Everybody say lightweight. The second type of weight is the medium weight. The medium weight represents weight that you can still lift, but it requires a little bit more focus, a little bit more energy. It's a little heavier. It ain't going to knock you completely off your rack, but you got to put in a little bit more effort. This represents some of the things in your life that you may have to be a little bit more intentional with, that you have to put a little bit more focus in, that you have to watch yourself a little. And you can lift it, but it's still a little strain. It's still a little heavy, but you can still lift it. The third type of way, oh, God, help me. Holy Spirit, activate. Whew, Holy Spirit, activate. Okay, the third type of weight, everybody say heavyweight. Heavyweight. Now, the heavyweight in our life represents the things that we cannot lift on our own will. We cannot lift with our own intellect. We cannot lift with our own money. These represent the things in our lives that every time we try to lift, it ends up crushing us. It ends up weighing down on us. It ends up falling right back on us. And a lot of us right now got some things that are heavy that we are lifting. This represents the sin that you don't tell nobody about. This represents the sin that you put down, but you keep going back to, and you're like, why can't I shake this? This represents the things in your life that you thought you let go, but they ain't let go of you. This represents the things in your life that you want to forget about. Maybe it's forgiveness. Maybe somebody hurt you, and they living their best life, and every time you try to let go, it keeps holding on to you. Maybe you had to cut ties with somebody you were attached to, and you're trying to move on. You're trying to heal, but every time you try to lift it, maybe it represents an addiction. What used to be one sip is now an everyday pit stop. What used to be puff, puff, pass, now you can't let a day go past without taking a puff. And all I'm trying to say, right, is y'all heard that quote, God will not put more on you than what you can bear? That's cool, but it's not that God will not put more on us than what we can bear. God never meant for us to bear the weight alone. So there's going to be moments in your life where you got to come within yourself. If it's your prayer closet, if it's in the car on the way to work, dropping your kids off at school, if it's in the break room in between breaks at work, I don't know. Somewhere in your life, you got to say, Holy Spirit, activate. Help me lift this hurt. Help me lift this pain. Help me lift what is drifting me away. And the very moment we finally ask the Holy Spirit to activate help for the heavy as the spotter for our lives, what was once unbearable now becomes bearable. What was once heavy to lift now comes a little bit easier. What was once unmanageable is now manageable. What was once excruciating is now alleviating. And all I'm trying to say is that you have to get help from the sponsor. That was heavy. Thank you, Robert. Minister Warren, where are you going? Notice how I'm still tired. Notice how I'm still tired. It's a little funny, but there's a deep hidden truth within this and I'm about to reveal. I'm still tired because the Holy Spirit doesn't lessen the load. The Holy Spirit strengthens the lift. See, same load, an extra lifter. And all I'm trying to say is that I want to read this quote too because I don't want you to miss it. God doesn't give us what we can handle. He gives us the Holy Spirit to help us handle what we are given. And some of y'all have been given some tough things, some rough things, some heavy things. And I came and tell you today that the Holy Spirit has activated in your life the whole time. Some of y'all think that God left you by yourself, that you was just lifting on your own. But I came to tell somebody right now that you've been through so much. You got some people who done been through this and that and all types of things. And I came to tell you that the Holy Spirit has been your spotter the whole time. You was asking God, where were you? Why would you allow this to happen? The Holy Spirit was there the whole time. And the reason that you were, the Holy Spirit was the reason that you were able to lift that season. And all I'm trying to say is that in order to do this, you have to, everybody say ask. You have to ask the Holy Spirit for help. See, a lot of us don't want to ask. Here's what the scripture says. You're not going to see this on the screen. Luke 11:13. Jesus talking, if you then give good gifts to your children, how much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? Raise your hand if you feel like you give good gifts to your children and youth. Should be every parent, hopefully. Jesus is saying to y'all, what is he saying? He said, to you who give good gifts to your children, how much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask? Not to those who whine, not to those who cry. And I know we like to shout, but even not to those who shout, to those who ask. See, I'll never forget when in 2014, raise your hand if you got an iPhone. Raise your hand if you got an Android. Ooh. Miss Myra raised two hands. She proud. Hey, you better rep that Android. She proud of it. But iPhone changed the game when they dropped voice command for Siri. And a lot of us go through life every day. Hey, Siri, what's my schedule? Hey, Siri, what time I got to be at work? Hey, Siri, what time am I supposed to pick up my pet, drop off my dog? Hey, Siri, what time am I supposed to do this and that? And you are asking Siri for help every single day. And you got so many Christians who go through life, they'll ask Siri for help before they ask the Holy Siri for help. Which leads me to my second point. The Holy Spirit activates, watch this now, pay attention to the wording. Everybody say bars. All right, let me go back to it. All right, the Holy Spirit activates in sudden winds to give you a wind. The Holy Spirit activates in sudden winds to give you a win. Minister One, what do you mean? See, in this scripture, it says that the Holy Spirit came. Well, let me read the scripture. Pull up the scripture, Acts 2, verses 2. Look at me, moving for the Spirit. On the day of Pentecost, that's when the Holy Spirit came, suddenly a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from the heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. So they was just chilling, and then all you hear is, and the Holy Spirit came like a violent wind. Suddenly. See, in this scripture, it says that when the Holy Spirit came, it suddenly came in the sound of a wind. And when you think of the definition of suddenly, it is spontaneous. It is out of the blue. It is out of nowhere. It's sudden. And it says that when the Holy Spirit came suddenly in the form of a wind, it then gave the wind, W-I-N, the wind. Minister Warren, what do you mean? In the text, now I need y'all to follow me because this is one of the deepest points. The wind was the Holy Spirit filling up the house. That was the wind, the Holy Spirit filling up the house. Minister Warren, what are you saying? All I'm trying to say is that when God wants to fill you up with winds, but God will do it sudden like a wind. Follow me here. What I'm trying to say is when you think about the wind, wind is sudden, right? Suddenly the wind comes, suddenly the wind goes, suddenly we feel the breeze of the wind, suddenly we don't, right? And figuratively speaking, the Holy Spirit activates winds in the form of a wind, but the issue is many of us miss our winds, W-I-N-S, because we're not able to tell when the Holy Spirit activates as a wind suddenly. Quick story. I wrote my first book in college as a senior in college, right? And I'll never forget, I actually started writing my book as I was on the Greyhound bus. I was traveling back home for Christmas break, and I was mad and upset because I couldn't think of a title for my a book, right? And I had been asking the Holy Spirit, what should I name my book? I need a title. And, you know, I'm sitting there chilling, and suddenly I heard an intercom. The bus driver is about to give instructions, right? And funny thing is, I always hated when the bus drivers gave instructions before we pulled off, simply because, like, I heard them all the time, right? They would always say, like, if you're using the bathroom, flush the toilet, don't have your feet in the aisle, throw all your snacks away, right? So I automatically thought that what this bus driver was about to say was really just irrelevant. So I grabbed my headphones, about to put them in, and then I felt the Holy Spirit tell me, just because it's sudden does not mean that it's not sent. Just because it's sudden does not mean that it's not sent. And I was urged to actually listen to the bus driver for the first time. So I said, okay, God, I took out my headphones. And the bus driver on the intercom said this. I feel led by the Holy Spirit to say this. I don't know who this is for, but I know who it is from. God has wanted me to tell you that you are being shaped for greater works, and this whole time you have been shaped for greater works. I was like, what? Those words penetrated my soul. And guess what the title of my first book was? Shaped for Greater Works. Full circle moment, because I want to make sure y'all get it, because I lost some of y'all a little bit. This moment was sudden like the wind. What did I say? The Holy Spirit activates sudden. The Holy Spirit activates winds as a sudden wind. Meaning this moment was literally like a sudden wind. Had I not known that it was the Holy Spirit coming like a sudden wind, W-I-N-D, I would not have recognized or received my wind, W-I-N. And all I'm trying to just let that sink in. All I'm trying to say is that some of y'all right now are missing your winds, W-I-N-S, because you're not able to recognize when the Holy Spirit is activating as a sudden wind. You having a conversation with somebody about how they know somebody who can literally help you and catapult you into your destiny, but instead of making that connection, you just say, oh, okay. Like, no, that was the Holy Spirit's sudden wind to give you a win. God used a bus driver. Nothing wrong with a bus driver, but the point is, I'm expecting a ride from a bus driver, not a word from a bus driver. Yeah, yeah. In the same way, God would use people around you, people who you never met, to say, oh, you got a speaking gift. Oh, you actually, you can really write. You ever thought about publishing a book? You ever thought about doing acting? You ever thought about doing this? And what is it? It's a sudden win activating to give you a win. There we go. It's connected. It's a sudden win. Trying to help y'all. I'm trying to help y'all. And as I conclude this point, you got some youth in here right now. Right? You got some youth in here right now. I almost missed my win because I was too plugged in. I was trying to put back in my headphones. You got some youth right now. Every time your parents try to tell you something, every time they try to correct you, you, I'm listening to my music. That's you. Parents, am I right? The counselor at school trying to give you a win. They're a sudden win trying to give you a win. They're old. They're not popular enough. These are sudden wins to give you a win. They're telling you things to help you because some kids don't have people in their lives who activate as sudden wins to give them wins. So be grateful that God surrounded you with sudden wins. We're getting there, y'all, I promise. But this is helping somebody. And right before I go to my third point, a lot of us don't want to go off sudden because we want to be all the way certain. A lot of us don't want to go off sudden because we want to be all the way certain. If God is sudden with you, it's because he's certain of you. God was sudden with me, giving me the title of my book, because he was certain that I could write it. God is sudden with you with sending you to college because he is certain that you could be the first one in your family to graduate. God is sudden with you starting that nonprofit because he was certain that you could save souls. If God is sudden with you because he's certain of you, I'm tired of people of the kingdom doubting their gifts, doubting their talents, doubting the things that God put in them. If he's sudden with you, he's certain of you. High schoolers, don't be afraid to go after that play. College students, don't be afraid to start that organization. Don't be afraid to go after. If he's sudden with you, that's because he's certain of you. Which leads me to my third point. This is why we have to be certain of the Holy Spirit's pool. Third point, the Holy Spirit will activate a pool that we feel when we don't have a plan we can see. The Holy Spirit will activate a pool we can feel when we don't have a plan we can see. 5 more minutes and we out. 1 Corinthians 2:14, but the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God because they are spiritually discerned. The natural man don't receive the things of God because these things are spiritually discerned. In other words, this scripture is saying that there are some things that you will receive from the Holy Spirit that you can't discern visually or physically, not even mentally, but you have to discern them spiritually. In other words, not being able to necessarily see with your eyes or hear with your ears, but to feel in your heart and feel within your soul. Sometimes God Holy Spirit will activate in a pool that you feel, right? And when I think about it, when you think about the Bible, right? Hear me when I say this carefully. The Bible will tell you that you are more than the conqueror, but it doesn't necessarily tell you what exactly to conquer when it comes to your actual professional or your personal. The Bible tells us and encourages us that we can be in community, that we can get married, but it don't tell you who your boo is. The point is, we need something that helps us feel the pull.
Robert?
It's my evil laugh. I got some up my sleeve. 3 more minutes and we out. Minister Warren, where are you going with this? See, we need to trust the pull of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit will activate a pull that you will feel. And Robert represents, everybody say us. Robert represents us. This rope represents the pull of the Holy Spirit. And what happens is, a lot of times, God will activate the Holy Spirit in the form of a pool. And what's going to happen with Robert is that once he feels the pool of the Holy Spirit, he's going to walk towards where he feels the pool. Whenever the pool stops, he is going to stop. And he's going to do it with his eyes closed, and technically he can't hear. In other words, the sensual is turned off. He has to feel the spiritual. And a lot of times, when the Holy Spirit activates a pool, we will feel a strong urge to go to this particular college. We will feel a particular urge to start this or to put this down or to leave this or to go there. Sometimes we'll stop. Then we'll feel another urge to actually start dating this person, to start courting that person, to actually leave that job and go start another career. Then we'll feel like we're stopped. And I really want to help some of y'all in this moment. If you don't hear nothing else, this is for everybody. See, a lot of us right now feel like what Robert is at right now. Robert right now is stopped. Robert is still. Minister Warren, where are you going? Right now, Robert cannot feel the Holy Spirit's what? Pool. But I can tell you that technically, although he can't feel the pool of the Holy Spirit, the rope is still wrapped around his waist, which technically means that he could still feel the presence of the Holy Spirit. And I just want to encourage some people right now, because you're thinking, God, why my Instagram followers ain't going up? God, why do I only get 2 views? God, how come I'm still jobless? God, how come I still don't have a car yet? How come all of my friends are doing well and doing this and graduating and going here, but how come I feel stuck? How come I feel worthless? How come I feel like you have abandoned me, you have left me, you have forsaken me? Why do I feel so still and invincible at the same time? And this is some of us right now so discouraged by being still. But I can tell you that just because you don't feel the Holy Spirit's pull does not mean that you don't feel the Holy Spirit's presence presently present in your life. Woo. And the Bible says after you have suffered for a little while. For a little while. For do not give up, because in due season you shall reap the harvest. As Robert is still, suddenly, the Holy Spirit will activate the pool again. And the funny thing is, Holy Spirit, you activating. Funny thing is, a lot of us right now with question, like, God, what are you doing? Why feel like I'm going backwards? I was just going forward. How did I lose another job? How come I didn't get that promotion? The house that you said was my house, how could you let somebody else? And we feel like we're going backwards. Ah. And the funny thing is, as the Holy Spirit pulls us, what will happen is the Holy Spirit will give provision for the vision. And the Holy Spirit will open your eyes. And the Holy Spirit, you'll see that the Holy Spirit is pulling you towards the right steps to take, the right doors to walk into, the right hands to shake. And the Holy Spirit will put you in a place where God will open doors that no man can shut. Ah. Pascal, I'm trying to help him. Trying to help him, Pascal. Funny thing is, both Robert and his family expressed and felt the pull of the Holy Spirit to activate ministry for his life. And the reason why he's up here is because of that. He trusted the pull. Every time we ask Robert to do invocation, he's doing invocation. He has questions. He wants to get it right. He's trusting the pool. Thank you, Robert. Appreciate it. Give it up for Robert. Hey, that's, I had like 5 quotes left, but the Holy Spirit activated enough. We good. Rise to your feet if you've been blessed by the word of God. Come on, give God a shout of praise. This is not me. This is the Holy Spirit activating. This is all God. And as we prepare to receive the invitation, if you are able, please rise. I must say this because they deserve it. I must say this. I wasn't even going to preach this sermon. When I found out that Pentecost Sunday fell on you Sunday, y'all seen that TikTok? Get somebody else to do it. I was like, Pastor, get somebody else to do it. And we were in a meeting, senior pastor, Pastor Sinkfield, Pastor Josh, Pastor Karen. They was like, you do it. You qualified to do it. And I said it to say that when the Holy Spirit is truly activating in your life, he'll activate confidence in you through other people. And if it had not have been for the Holy Spirit activating in them to get to me, I probably would have just psyched myself out of being in this moment. This is the most important decision you can ever make in your life. The Holy Spirit, we can receive because of Jesus. You have 3 choices. First one is that you can dedicate your life for the first time by simply walking down, and we will receive you at the altar. If you never gave your life to Christ, now is the time. All you gotta do is say yes and walk. Robert just showed us. Say yes and walk. The doors of the church are now open. Will you come? The second decision is you can rededicate your life. Same rules apply. Say yes and walk down. Robert just showed us. And the third choice, you can join this church, not necessarily as a member for status, but as a member for community and love and nurturing. Will you come? The doors of the church are now open. Is there somebody else that the Holy Spirit is activating in? Even if you want to just tell the Lord sorry for what you've been through. Is there anybody else? Can we bring the music down just a little bit? Musicians, y'all are so awesome. The Holy Spirit is saying that there's somebody right now, you've been coming week after week, and you've been thinking about joining, you've been thinking about giving your life to Christ. Why wait? Tomorrow's not promised. There's somebody in here. Will you come? There it is. At this time, I will now turn it over to Pastor Karen. Give God a shout of praise.